Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, why is it that when you go to the Reflow Editor, you're not seeing the text on the left side, but you are seeing it on the slides on the right? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if this has ever been a problem for you, go ahead, subscribe, ring the bell icon, leave me a comment, all that. So, I just recorded a tutorial on how to bring multiple languages into ProPresenter 7, and if you didn't see that one, go ahead and search for it, follow the link, etc. You need to watch that if that's something that you'll run into. But part of that was that sometimes it was the case that the slide wasn't showing in the left-hand side of Reflow Editor. So I thought that if someone accidentally was in a situation like that, maybe they would want to figure this out. So let me head over to my computer and we'll just take a look at that. So let me just select a song here. A Mighty Fortress Is Our God is probably good. So let me real quick, actually let me select all, and then I'm going to apply a theme to this. So I'm going to do the two languages theme, and I'm going to second text box top in Z order. And you'll see what this, I mean, it moves stuff up, but it didn't apparently do anything other than that here. But if we go into the Reflow Editor, look here on the left-hand side. None of these slides have text in them. What's going on there? Over here it has text, so why isn't it showing here? Well, it's actually very simple. So let's go back into show mode. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got a either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. And let's edit. I guess I could have skipped directly to that. Ignore down here. That doesn't have anything to do with it. Where it has something to do with it is right here. So this is our text box where the text is located. But it is the second text box in this order. So the first text box in the order is actually down here, and it doesn't have anything in it. So just to show you this, I'm just going to drag this down, putting text with no number on top of text 2, and that's on slide 1 and slide 1 only. So if we go back to Reflow, notice this seems to have fixed it, and that's what's going on. So again, just to show you, click on the edit again, click on slide 2, and change the order once again, and go to Reflow, and now slide 2 is fixed. So what you need to know about Reflow is that if there are multiple objects on a slide, whatever the first one is, that's the one that Reflow affects. It doesn't affect the second or any subsequent objects. In this case, we had 2 text boxes, and it didn't affect the second text box, which was the one that actually had the words in it. So that's what's going on, is that they just need to be in the correct order in that box in the lower left-hand corner. It's actually 3D space, so those 2 text boxes are not on the same plane. If you think back to high school geometry, they're not even with one another. One of them is slightly in front of the other. Even though they're not overlapping in this example, one is slightly in front. So if you look at my hand, this hand is slightly in front of this hand. But if I turn it this way, it looks like they're on the same plane, and that's what's going on. So if you have that problem, that's the very first thing I would check, is I would go into the editor and see if the text box with the words in it is the topmost object. If it's the case that you need it not to be the topmost objects, what I would do is I would create a theme where everything is identical, only the order has changed, because that can be saved with the theme. Apply that, fix it in Reflow Editor, whatever you need to do, combine slides, split slides, etc. And then go back to your original theme where those two in that lower left-hand corner are switched, and then you'll be good from there on out. So that's what I would do, and that's how to solve that. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro, the number 7, and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.